When you see Wimbledon white with Guardsman blue stripes, your mind only thinks of one car, a Shelby. And this week's Muscle Car of the Week is a pristine 65 Shelby GT350. When the Mustang first came out, you could go to your local Ford dealer and pick up a GT Mustang with the K-code HiPo 271 horse 289 V8 under the hood, and it had a few other details that made it a good performer. But if you wanted to go racing and be competitive, you really needed to step up the game, and that's where the Shelby GT350 came from. It was a highly thought out car that was designed to be a competitive racer that anybody could go buy. So they took a 1965 Mustang, they gutted a lot of the sound deadener out of it, they redesigned the front suspension with some lowered front control arms, bigger sway bar, upgraded the brakes, they put a 4-speed in it with specially treated gears, a 9-inch rear end with a Detroit locker. Up front, you've got the fiberglass hood, there's no latch, you've got hood pins to hold it down. The original Shelby fiberglass hoods were very nice pieces. When you open them up, they've got a smooth finish support underneath, and you can see the fiberglass netting, but they fit together pretty nice and they look really good. Power for a GT350 is from a 289 cubic inch V8, and this is very similar to the K-code Mustang engine. In 65, all the K-codes were also 4-speeds, much like the Shelby's. And then they beefed up that 271 horse K-code V8 with a bigger Holley carburetor, a lightweight aluminum intake manifold, some Cyclone headers, and you ended up with something that made about 306 horsepower instead of the 271. It also made more torque, it had a quicker ratio steering system. But this is different because Shelby added a higher rise intake manifold. They got a little more hood clearance with this scoop, and that bumped the power level to just over 300. And this also has the special Shelby bracing under the hood, and the restoration on this car is just phenomenal. It is called a thoroughbred restoration, which means there are no aftermarket parts. These are all real original Ford or Shelby parts. All the finishes are spot on, and the further proof that it's a real Shelby comes from the serial tag, which is here on the fender. This one is number 5S329. 5 being 65, S being Shelby, and this is number 329. The interior is basically a gutted version of a Mustang. You've got performance seat belts, of course the 4-speed transmission, the gauge pack on the dash pad, the wood-rimmed Cobra wheel, deletes on everything else. I mean, everything about this car was designed to make it lighter, faster, and to be able to handle better so it would be a competent race car. And that's one of the things that's so unique about these is how well thought out they were. In fact, there really wasn't many options. The only options were the addition of the blue stripes. All the cars were Wimbledon white. And you had a choice in wheels, a stamp steel painted wheel, or you could get a Shelby Krager wheel. But everything about these things was race ready off the showroom floor. Again, because it's got some restoration elements, it's a little bit nicer than the Shelbys were when they were new, but this would be everything that you'd get if you bought one back in 65. Now, there were competition models that took the base GT350 and made it even more of a race car, and you could add all kinds of stuff to those. You went to your Shelby dealer, and you could add multiple carburation, you could add a competition rear window that was plexiglass and even lighter weight. You know, more go-fast goodies. I think this is one of the coolest cars in the Brothers collection because not only is it a GT350, which, you know, they only made 562 of these things new, but it's one of the nicest GT350s on the planet. And when you look at the condition of these kind of cars, you got to realize that these were race cars. So a lot of them got raced, they got wrecked, they got repaired. And then when the value started to go up, they were getting restored. And when people would restore these cars, they would use the parts that were available to put them back together. And sometimes there were reproduction parts that, you know, looked like what came on the car, but they weren't the actual, you know, original parts that came on the car. So for this reason, the Mustang Club of America came up with a gold level thoroughbred award. And what that means is that the car's been restored, but every part on it is date coded, factory original NOS original parts that came on these cars from the factory. So for example, if you had any part that was on the car, you didn't go to the parts store and buy a new one. You researched and found an original Ford part, original Shelby part, and put it on the car. The serial number and the date code on the part has to be older than the car, because the parts were made and then the car was built. And you can imagine what it takes to make a gold level thoroughbred car. Every single piece on this thing has to be correct. But as more of these cars were becoming, showing up on the restored scene, we were seeing cars that appeared to be NOS, gold level thoroughbreds, but they still weren't 100% sure. So they created an even rarer certificate of authenticity. Once a car got judged to be a gold thoroughbred, it gets judged again. And if it is truly certified that everything on this thing is exactly as it would have come from the factory, it receives that award. There's, probably less than 10 of these that have ever been judged with both of those certifications, and this is one of them. It's also cool that the ownership heritage of this car is highly documented. Everybody who's owned this car is known, how long they've had it, what they did to it. In fact, a lot of the almost impossible to find paperwork and documentation is still with this car. The GT350 came with Koni racing shocks, and they provided a little pamphlet in the glove box when you bought the car. The original Koni shock brochure is still with this car. Other things that are kind of mind-blowing, the tires. These are Goodyear Blue Dot tires. These aren't new tires that are reproductions designed to look like Goodyear Blue Dots. These are a nearly 50-year-old set of Goodyear Blue Dot tires. I love the look of these cars, and one thing that you don't really notice is how well the wheel and tire fit the car. I mean, the tire fills up the wheel arches perfectly, but what is kind of silly is how narrow the rear tires are. I mean, they obviously expected to pull these before you go racing, because these would just get annihilated. And the car, it's a museum quality, trailered showpiece, but it starts up and runs and drives. And these guys, they start up to move it around. They don't put a lot of miles on the car, obviously, because it is very, very significant, but it shows that it's a complete functioning working car. It's super, super cool. One question that people sometimes ask, and there's kind of a funny story behind it, I can't say that it's true, but people ask, why is it called the GT350? It had 306 horsepower, a 289 cubic inch engine, nothing lined up with 350. And the rumor is, Carroll Shelby once asked, how far is it from the office to the workshop? And one of his crew members said, 350 feet. And he said, then it's a GT350. Don't know if it's true, but it's super cool. And so is this car. And we were glad to bring it to you on this episode of Muscle Car of the Week. Being a Shelby, there is tons and tons of information about these things online and in books and in clubs. So you can always find out more about those cars in general. This one has more pictures on our website at MuscleCarOfTheWeek.com. Of course, you can always check the Facebook page for the sneak peek of next week's car and our YouTube channel. When you hit the subscribe button, you're guaranteed the next video every time, and you'll never miss one.